Yesterday I went a little bit of whisky shopping and went to one of my favorite stores that do offer the opportunity to try it before you buy it. And what did I find? Well, you've seen from the thumbnail, I've got myself a Springbank 13 local barley bottled at 54.1%. And natural color, non-filtered. So very excited about it. And while I've gone to that store numerous times, they know who I am, they know I make videos. So one of the guys were very friendly, showed me around, what can I show you, what's new. They also had a 27-year-old whiskey there. A little bit expensive, but and I saw this local barley. Now I've become a little bit of a, not maybe a super fan of Springbank. I've got the 10-year-old, I've tried the 17, the 18, I've tried a couple of them, a little bit above my pay grade, but I saw this one. I said definitely I'm gonna have to try it. Not cheap. If you want to buy the bottle, it's 135 euros here in Belgium, but I'm super excited that we can actually get it now in Belgium. I got a 10-year-old, I think 80-85 euros, and this one better cask strength, 13 years old. So I was, of course, I'm going to have to buy myself the sample. Now, if I only had a sample bottle left, there was so much left in the bottle. So quite a couple of drams out of it. And 15 euro for the sample. And I gladly parted with my money to give this one a try to see, am I going to buy it or not? So welcome to the Whisky Lover Society, Michard Retief, getting right into the business. Well, before we start with the business, please remember to like, share and subscribe. Help out some kids in South Africa. Thanks for all my Patreons. I have three of them that give money, not for me. It's for kids in South Africa. Every month we send money to support 75 of them. And thank you very much also for the super chats. That really helps boost the channel's income a little bit, and 100% goes towards the kids. Not for whisky. I don't buy whisky with donations. It's for the kids. So back to the whisky. Color-wise, it is a nice, maybe a golden, darker golden color. Maturation-wise, it is a mixture between ex-bourbon and ex-sherry cask. 60% bourbon, 60% sherry. If you look at it, it is 13 years old, natural color. So, but not a lot of the sherry cask influence. Definitely not an overactive or very wet cask. If you look at the color, if you compare a whiskey like Glenallachie, for example, 10-year-old, it's going to be much darker, of course, much more sherry into it. So looking forward to this. 15 euros for a sample. I really hope it is worth it. So on the nose, cheers. Oh my word. Now, this is it's lovely. It's light. It's friendly. It's delicate. And that sherry, 40% sherry, didn't really bring a lot to it, but I am still happy with it. That sweetness, there's a fruity component, a tropical fruit component that comes in. There's a perfuminess, that's a lightness. I get a little bit of a vanilla. And then I get maybe the fruit component, a little mixture between a banana And a little bit of a, there's a mango, a dried mango component. Oh my word, this is lovely. Even at that high ABV, 54.1, if I give it a little bit of a unhealthy, shaky, shaky, I don't get it. There's almost, it feels like there's no alcohol in it. It feels even less than 40% for me. Wow, that is really nice. I think if you give this whiskey to anybody, even somebody that's not really a whiskey drinker, even maybe my wife, which hates whiskey, this is absolutely lovely and friendly. There's a little bit of a honey note appearing, and then I get a hint of that wood, but it's a tiny amount at the back. Oh, it's going to be good. On a taste, cheers. Ooh. I am not sure what I'm picking up, but for that split second, I thought there could be a hint of a smoke in it. I don't know, I think it is just the idea that there should be smoke in some of the Springbank whiskies. But it just, I don't know, I think I'm completely wrong. The palate is broken, but I just got that hint of that. The sweetness is lovely. Even that high ABV, I took a little bit too big a sip, but it did not burn that much. There's not that evaporation when you get to the 60s. You get that instant evaporation feeling. That didn't get any of that. It is lovely. It's sweet. That fruity component is there. That vanillas are there. Just want to make sure. Cheers. Mmm. It just smooth as silk. It does leave my mouth a little bit dry. It took out all the moisture from it. A little dry mouth feel. A hint of a tannin also appearing. It's a little bitter note. Just like if it's from a scale to from 1 to 10, maybe a half of it. But it does beg for you to come back a little bit more. Now, am I going to add water to this one? I don't think I'm going to add water to this one. It just feels like they bottled it at the perfect strength. Now, each year, they pick a different farm, apparently. And say that farm get commissioned to produce the next year's local barley. This one was produced by a farm called Glencraigs with the barley variety called Belgravia. So each year is going to be probably not that different, but each year there will be a different variety. So 2024 this one, and I must say I've never tried the 2023 and 2022. So for me, on this one, oh my word, 2024 edition was really a fantastic whiskey. Something that I would recommend if you are in the sweeter type of whiskies, maybe not that shocking whiskies. Not a super complex whiskey, but it's super drinkable. So that's me, the Springbank Local Barley 2024 edition. €135. Is it worth it? Absolutely. Go out, buy it if you can find it. 8,400 bottles, if I remember correctly. So it is available. Just go do a little bit of search. So thank you very much. And please remember to like, share and subscribe. Cheers.